It's really a great honor and privilege for me to stand here and be able to speak to you.
Je to naozaj veľká česť a privilégium, že tu môžem stať pred vami a hovoriť k vám.
This would not have been possible without the Father Heart Ministry.
A toto by nebolo možné, keby neexistovala táto služba Otcovo srdce.
So I'd just like to tell you a little bit about my journey so far.
A takže by som vám rád povedal niečo o mojej doterajšej ceste.
I was born into a Catholic family with six brothers and one sister.
Narodil som sa do katolíckej rodiny, mal so šiestimi bratmi a jednou sestrou.
My father died when I was four.
Môj otec zomrel, keď som mal 4 roky.
And life for my mother was extremely difficult.
A život mojej mamy bol extrémne ťažký.
And I have vague recollections, and my sister used to tell me.
A v mojich spomienkach si tak matne spomínam, ako mi sestra hovorila.
That because I was the last one, I was the baby, there wasn't enough time to give me the love and affection I needed.
Že keďže som bol posledný, bol som vlastne bábetko, tak nebolo nikdy dosť času na mňa, na to, aby sa mi dostávalo lásky, pozornosti.
My mother had a very strong faith and she did all that she could possibly do for each and every one of us children.
A moja mama mala veľmi silnú vieru a robila všetko, čo bolo v jej silách pre každé jedno dieťa.
But I now know that what she was unable to provide, love, affection, and the cuddling, and the cooing, and all of those things that mothers should do, she didn't have time for.
A ja teraz viem, že ona vtedy jednoducho nemala čas na to, aby sa so mnou bláznila, aby sa so mnou túlila, aby mi prejavovala tú priazeň a lásku, akú matka má prejavovať svojmu dieťaťu, pretože jednoducho nemala čas na to.
So I grew up and I didn't know any of these things.
Takže som vlastne vyrastal bez toho, aby som poznal tieto veci.
I just thought I'm just like other people.
A ja som si myslel, že však som taký, aký, ako každý ostatný.
But I know now that deep in my heart I was searching for love.
Ale teraz viem, že vo svojom hlboko v srdci som túžil a hľadal lásku.
I got married when I was 25.
Keď som mal 25, tak som sa oženil.
To an exceedingly beautiful young girl.
Zobral som si nádhernú mladú ženu.
Took my breath away.
Ktorá mi vyrazila dých.
And I thought, it's going to be fine from now on.
A myslel som si, tak, a odteraz to bude všetko super.
The love that I've been searching for has arrived.
Tá láska, na ktorú som čakal, ktorú som hľadal, je tu.
But I didn't understand the issues that were in my heart through my upbringing.
Ale ja som ešte nechápal tie veci, ktoré som mal v srdci, ktoré som prijal skrze tú moju výchovu v detstve.
And I was yet to find the problems that Jenny, my wife, brought with her.
A ešte ma čakalo spoznávať aj problémy mojej manželky Jenny, ktorú ona si zo sebou priniesla.
They were pretty well opposites.
Alebo tieto naše problémy boli dosť opačné.
So I kept trying to get the love I wanted from her.
Ja som sa stále snažil získať tú lásku, ktorú som potreboval od nej.
And she was looking for things like steadiness, support, encouragement from me.
A ona hľadala veci ako istotu, podporu, povzbudenie odo mňa.
Somewhere in the middle it all went wrong.
A niekde tam medzi nami vlastne to celé zlyhávalo, narážalo.
Finally, it was my wife first, she found Jesus.
A nakoniec bola to moja manželka, ktorá prvá vlastne spoznala Ježiša.
And a few weeks later, I also gave my heart to Jesus.
A pár týždňov na to som aj ja odovzdal svoje srdce Ježišovi.
I knew before that that I was not a good person.
Ja som predtým vedel o sebe, že nie som dobrý človek.
And I had many nightmares about the end of the world and I was going to hell.
A veľakrát sa mi snívalo, mal som také nočné mory, že je koniec sveta a že ja idem do pekla.
Having met Jesus, life was suddenly so wonderful.
A keď som stretol Ježiša, zrazu bol život tak nádherný.
I dreamed of being able to have a second chance.
A snívalo sa mi o tom, že mám novú šancu.
And this was for me the second chance.
A toto bola tá nová šanca pre mňa.
And life was good for quite a while.
A život bol naozaj dobrý dosť dlhý čas.
I also received the Holy Spirit.
A tiež som prijal Ducha Svätého.
And that was an equally big step in my life.
A to bol rovnako veľký krok v mojom živote.
But then life went on.
Ale potom život išiel ďalej.
And the problems were still there.
A zistil som, že problémy tam stále ešte sú.
And I didn't know what was wrong.
A ja som nevedel, kde je problém.
As Robert shared earlier, I was still looking for Jenny to solve my problems.
Tak ako aj Robert predtým spomínal, ja som stále čakal, že Jenny vyrieši moje problémy.
And I got very angry from time to time when I could see she was asking me to solve hers.
A ja som sa z času na čas veľmi nahneval, keď som videl, že ona očakáva, že ja vyrieším jej problémy.
So after at the age of 37, you know, that was when I received Jesus, in 2011, there was an opportunity to go to Wales, to Lake Barlow, where Robert and Vicky were running a Father Heart course.
Keď som sa obrátil, mal som 37 rokov, ale v roku
2011.
Roku 2011 som mal príležitosť ísť do Walesu, kde Robbie a Vicky robili jednu akciu.
Yeah, my faith was very low and I didn't want to go.
Moja viera bola veľmi slabá vtedy a ja som nechcel ísť.
And on the first occasion we had a whole week's course. And for me, nothing changed.
A bolo to vlastne, trvalo to celý týždeň a pre mňa, u mňa sa nič nezmenilo.
Jenny received something exciting.
Jenny prijala nejaké zrušujúce, zaujímavé veci.
So what's new? It's she gets it and I don't.
Takže nič nové. Ona zase niečo dostala a ja zase nič.
So we went again.
Takže sme tam išli znova.
And I was again feeling, oh, I won't receive anything, there's nothing special here.
A ja som mal také očakávanie, že zase to nič nebude pre mňa, že nič zase nedostanem.
And it was the last day.
A posledný deň.
And I was all ready, getting ready to depart, saying, there you go.
Keď už som sa chystal na to, že odídem s tým, že povie, že no, tak zase to isté.
When there was a knock on my door.
Niekto zaklopal na moje dvere.
And I opened the door and there was Vicky.
Ja som otvoril dvere a bola tam Vicky.
And there's a bony finger pointed at me.
A ukázala na mňa jej prstom.
You haven't met with Father yet, have you?
Ty si sa ešte nestretol s otcom, že?
No.
Ne?
So we made a special arrangement after the next teaching that she would with deal with the situation through prayer.
Takže sme sa dohodli, že po ďalšom vyučovaní sa mi bude venovať a bude sa za mňa modliť.
And she talked about how I felt about Father God.
A vlastne pýtala sa ma, ako sa cítim alebo aký mám pocit z Boha Otca.
And we had a conversation for a while.
A chvíľu sme sa bavili.
And she eventually said, I think we need to go back.
A ona potom povedala, že myslím, že sa musíme vrátiť.
Go back to when you were born.
A vrátiť do toho obdobia, keď si sa narodil.
So she prayed and I tried to sense what was going on.
Takže ona sa modlila, ja som sa snažil vnímať, čo sa deje.
And Vicky said, it's the day for you to be born.
A Vicky povedala, teraz je ten deň, kedy sa máš narodiť.
What are you thinking?
Čo si teraz myslíš, čo cítiš?
And I was thinking, I don't want want to be born. It's
A ja som si pomyslel, ja sa nechcem narodiť.
It's not safe out there.
Nie je to tam bezpečné.
So she said, let's go back even further. Let's say to the day that your mother, already with 7 children, is finding out or found out you are pregnant again.
Takže vráťme sa ešte ďalej do minulosti, povedala Vicky, keď ešte ťa tvoja mama čakala a vedela, že má 7 detí a je zase tehotná.
So I sensed these words.
A ja som vnímal tieto slova.
From my mother.
Mojej mami.
Oh no, not again.
Ach nie, nie zasa.
And something happened at that time.
A niečo sa vtedy stalo.
I was very emotional.
Ja som bol zrazu veľmi rozrušený.
So I shed a few tears and drenched Vicky's top.
Takže som vyplakal nejaké slzy a úplne som premočil Vickynu košelu.
After a little while I was a bit more composed.
A potom som sa po chvíli pozbieral.
And she said, okay, let's go back to the day you're going to be born.
A ona povedala, dobre, tak teraz poďme znova k tomu dňu, kedy si sa narodil.
What do you sense? What do you see?
Čo teraz cítiš, vnímaš?
And I sensed that I was being born into the hands and arms of Father God.
A ja som vtedy vnímal, že sa rodím do rúk a do náručia Boha Otca.
And that was the beginning of me finding the love that I so desperately had needed all of my life.
A to bolo začiatok toho, kedy som nachádzal, konečne našiel tú lásku, po ktorej som tak zúfalo túžil celý život.
Being here is a part of what Father said to me.
To, že som tu, je súčasťou toho, čo mi Boh Otec povedal.
We will have adventures together.
Budeme spolu zažívať dobrodružstva.
And these times for me are adventures.
A tieto časy, keď sme tu, sú pre mňa tými dobrodružstvami.
I wish in a way that you known me before.
Ako si trocha si prajem, aby ste ma poznali, aký som bol predtým.
I was withdrawn.
Ja som bol veľmi
antisocial.
A taký asociálny skoro.
Didn't have any friends.
Nemal som žiadnych kamarátov.
Could certainly not speak in front of an audience like this.
Rozhodne som nebol schopný rozprávať pred ľuďmi ako teraz.
And all of these things have changed because Father's love has entered my heart and has been working there ever since.
A toto všetko sa zmenilo, pretože Božia otcovská láska vstúpila do môjho srdca a odtedy tam koná a prebýva.
I still have a beautiful wife.
Stále ešte mám nádhernú ženu.
This year we've been married 51 years.
Tento rok je to 55 rokov, čo sme zobratí.
And I'm looking forward to it being even better in the future.
A teším sa na to, že sa budeme mať ešte lepšie v budúcnosti.
Thank you.
Ďakujem vám.